Hey guys, welcome back to a new video by Biology with Zhang Xuan. So today we are going to do the 0610/63 May-June 2023 Paper 6 Alternative to Practical. So the paper will be in the description box below, so make sure you check it out. So let's start solving this paper. Alright, let's go. Question 1. A student investigated the nutrient content of 3 types of drinks. Drink A, drink B, and drink C. The student used these methods for the 3 tests on each of the drinks. Test 1, testing for reducing sugars, label 3 test tube A, B, C, put 1 cm cube of drink A into test tube A, put 1 cm cube for drink B into test tube B, put 1 cm cube of drink C into test tube C. Add 1 cm cube of Benedict vegan to each test tube, put all 3 test tubes into a hot water bath, start the stop clock and leave the test tube in the water bath for 5 minutes. After 5 minutes, remove the test tube from the water bath, observe and record the colors in each test tube. So for testing of starch, it's similar, but it's now placing 2 drops of each drink into a white towel and observe and add 2 drops of iodine solution and observe and record the color. For test 3, it's protein, same steps as reducing sugar, but you're adding a burette vegan to each drink sample and observing the record and colors in each test tube. Part A, the student observations are shown in figure 1.1. Test 1 drinks A and B were blue, C was brick red. Test 2 drinks B and C were both brown and A was blue-black. Test 3 drinks B and C were both lilac while A was blue. So part 1 says prepare a table to record the colors observed by the student for all 3 tests for each drink. Do not include conclusions in your table. So this is just roughly the table that drawn. You might have a different one as long as the all of the record data is inside and a proper table will be acceptable as 4 marks. Okay. Part 2. State which nutrients are present in each drink. So when you see drink A, right, C was brick red. So it means that there is reducing sugar, or you can say starch. For drink B, we can see they were both brown and A was blue-black. So blue-black, we know it will be protein. And drink C is protein and reducing sugar because lilac and blue is present. Okay. Part 3. Identify 1 safety hazard associated with test 1. So you see test 1, right? They are putting in a water bath. So the water bath, right, is definitely maintaining a particular temperature. So we are assuming that the water could be hot. Part B. The vitamin C content, the fat content of 3 other drinks D, E, and F were determined. It was found that drink D contained vitamin C, drink E contained fat, and drink F contained vitamin C and fat. Part 1 says state the reagent used when testing for vitamin C, DCPIP. Part 2, describe the method for emulsion test for fats. So it's to add ethanol, add water, then shake so that ethanol and water can be mixed together. Part 3, the results for 1 of the drinks are shown in table 1.1. So you can see test vitamin C, the solution is colorless, fat, a white emulsion has formed. Identify the drink from the results provided in table 1.1, which is drink F, because both vitamin C and fat are both present. Explain how you identified the drink from the results provided in table 1.1. Very free, it's 3 marks, so both vitamin C and fat is present in the drink, okay? Part C, the 3 types of food contain different concentration of the enzyme catalase. Catalase catalyzes the breakdown of hydrogen peroxide to release water and oxygen gas. The production of oxygen gas can be used to measure the activity of the enzyme. Plan an investigation to compare the concentration of catalase in the three types of food. So prepare the apparatus for the investigation. The food samples are first cut into correct proportion and is weighed accurately using a balance. The food is then stirred along with hydrogen peroxide. The mass, the surface area of the food, the volume and the concentration of hydrogen peroxide will remain the same. The volume of gas will be measured using a gas syringe when it's produced. Safety gloves will require to be worn to prevent cuts when using a knife during the cutting of the food samples, and the whole process should be repeated at least 2 times for more accurate results. Okay. Question 2A. The nutrient content of foods can affect a person's bone. In a study, the diet of and bone density of 120 women were monitored for 2 years. The women were all between 50 and 70 years of age. The scientists calculated the mean daily calcium intake for each woman and measured the change in density of one of their bones by using X-ray scans. The results for 5 of the women are shown in table 2.1. So you have to plot a graph, linear graph on the grid of the data in table 2.1, and one axis has been started for you. So just draw this graph. You can pause the video and have a look at this. So make sure your one is accurate and you make sure using a ruler to draw. And that's how you get your 4 marks. Make sure units is also part of the axis. Part 2. State 2 conclusions for the data in your graph. So the higher the calcium intake, there will be increase in bone density. Or the lower the calcium intake, the bone density will decrease. Okay. Part 3. Identify the independent variable in this investigation, the calcium intake. Part 4. Describe 2 variables that the scientists should have considered when selecting women for the studies. The health status of the woman and the age of the woman. Okay. Part 5. Suggest a reason for a large number of women being included in the study. So it's to help to identify anomalies. So this is an example of why you need to have a large sample of representatives so that you're easily to identify anomalies. Part 6. State one way this study is not representative of the population because it has no men, it only has women. Okay, if you have both of them, then you can say this is a population. Alright. Part 7. A student stated that more women were losing bone mass than were gaining bone mass. Explain why this statement may not be correct for the data in this study. Because the category is unknown, we don't know what is it linking to. So that's why we need to say that the category or the whatever is happening is unknown. It's not actually known in this investigation. Part B. Figure 2.1 is a photograph of a femur, which is a bone in the leg. Part 1. Make a large drawing of the bone shown in figure 2.1. So how do you get 4 marks? It's by make sure you're having clear and continuous line, no shading. The size is greater than the line length of line P and Q, which is here to here. And then detail 1 is the projection of top left. So it means make sure you must draw this. And then lines on the medial condyle on the far left. So it's also make sure you're having both of them lah. Okay. Part 2. The length of line PQ represents the length of the femur in figure 2.1. Measure the length of the line PQ on figure 2.1. So the length of the line on figure 2.1 is about 140 mm, or you can put 141 plus minus 1. Okay. So about maybe it could be 139 or it could be 141 mm. Both are acceptable. Use your measurement and the formula to calculate the actual length of the bone. Give your answer to 3 significant figures, space for working. So just use I divided by M, which is 140 divided by 0.3, you get 466.66666. So in 3 significant figures would be 467 millimeters. Part 3. Figure 2.2 shows a bone from a person who had vitamin D deficiency. State 2 ways that the bone in figure 2.2 is different from the bone in figure 2.1. So you can see that the in this diagram is straight and this one is curved in shape. And you can see that this one is long and in figure 2.2 is shorter in length. So that is how you make a comparison. So that's all for this paper. It's quite simple, very straightforward. So if you realize that you haven't copied down or find the correct answer, make sure you pause the video and have a look. If there's a mistake, please let me know in the comments below and I will definitely review and respond back to you in the comments. So hope to see you guys in the next video. Bye bye.